Mr. Ditlow grew up in, he was born in Augusta, Georgia, grew up in Camp Hill, Pennsylvania, has degrees from Lehigh University, Georgetown, a law degree, and a doctorate from Harvard. He has previously been as a patent examiner at the U.S. Patent Office from 1965 to 1970, and an attorney for Public Interest Research Group from 71 to 75. How long have you been with the Center for Auto Safety?
Oh, I've been with the Center for Auto Safety since 1975, or a little over 20 years now.
Well, we're seeing this act as a disincentive to car sales. Consumers who are looking at 1991 models want a passenger side airbag, and they're actually deferring the purchase until the 1992 model year, when there will be a wider range of cars with passenger side airbags. So the sooner we get the passenger bag in to the consumers who want to know where it is, the faster we'll see car sales increase. Over the next 10 years, General Motors engineers, time and time again, had data showing that its pickups were in fact rupturing within the gas tanks in crashes, not at 50, not at 40, but often at 30 and 20 miles per hour.
My son came to dinner on April the 9th, 1989. On the morning of April 10th, he was burned alive in his pickup.
These vehicles are killers that go up in flames in moderate impacts. And all anyone has to do is look at a photo of one of these real-world GM pickups to see that the vehicle survived, but the occupants burned alive.
I'd like to point out just one other document that's over here. There's a document there where a General Motors Vice President, Alex Mayer, said that this was a probable, easy fix. Now, the Department of Transportation may very well have that document buried somewhere in its files. But did they ask General Motors, what do you mean a probable easy fix? And that probable easy fix cost General Motors $23.
NHTSA refuses to release that information, which the American public paid for. And yesterday, we filed a lawsuit in federal district court to obtain the identity by make and model of NHTSA's crash test results so that we can tell the American public what neither the government nor NHTSA nor the automakers are willing to do. Which models are safer?
When you look at the total cost of motor vehicle accidents, over $170 billion each year, society pays for that cost. We pay for medical care for quadriplegics. We pay for families. There's tremendous lost income. So the fact is, and lost earnings from the people who are killed in accidents. So the fact is that the government has a major interest in highway safety.
NHTSA did miss this defect. And for NHTSA to say that it does not know how an advanced airbag system that it mandated works is simply an omission of incompetency from the agency.
Here's what the Center for Auto Safety does, our work on. We, today, when I became the director, we could afford a 30-second commercial in the Super Bowl. That's what the auto companies talk about, how many commercials they get on the Super Bowl. Today, we're down to less than 5 seconds of a commercial Super Bowl ad. So we're looking at a budget of what we do of less than $500,000 a year. So we do a lot on a little. We do it on patience. We do it on inspiration. We do it on good staff. We do it on solid research. We do it on good data. It's a tough job, but someone's got to do it.